It's me again, Morgan Freeman. I'm going to read you another story. But since it's almost Christmas, I'm going to do a Christmas story. It's called A Pirate's Night Before Christmas by Philip Yates. 'Twas the night before Christmas aboard the Black Sark. Not a creature was stirring, not even a shark. The stockings were hung on the bowsprit with tar, in hopes that Sir Peggotty soon would be there. The pirates were snoring like pigs in their beds, while visions of treasure chests danced in their heads. And I, with my spyglass and my scruffy old dog, stood watching the crow's nest for ships in the fog. When out in the mist there arose such a racket, I slid down the mast with me sword to attack it. Away to the poop deck I ran very fast. I threw off the anchor and shouted, "Avast!" Straight up from the sea in a foamy white spray flew 8 giant seahorses pulling a sleigh. A mean-looking driver, a-hoisting one leg. Well, shiver me timbers, it must be Sir Peg. More sluggish than flounders, his coursers they came. And he whistled and snarled and called them by name. Now Salty, now Scurvy, and Sinbad and Molly, on cutthroat and cross-eyed on Roger and Jolly. To the top of the sail, to the top of the mast. Now dash away, dash away, dash away fast. And then with a cry and a crack of his whip, down came his sleigh on the deck of our ship. An old jolly sea dog, enormously fat, and so was the parrot perched on his hat. He was dressed in all black from his head to his heels. His clothes were all covered with seaweed and eels. His eye, how it twinkled, his dreadlocks, how twiny. His scars were like crossbones, his gold tooth, how shiny. His mouth was turned up with a nasty old look, and the silver gleamed sharp at the end of his hook. A scary white skull he had hung on his ear soon let me know I had nothing to fear. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his sack and stuffed all the stockings with coins and hardtack. The Black Sark was soon filled with holiday cheer and loaded with gifts for each good buccaneer. Anchors and hornpipes and crackle fruit eggs, pearls and red sashes for Bonnie and Meg. A cauldron for cook filled with spices of shank, and just for the cap'n, a shiny new plank. But oh, me broken heart and tears in my eyes. I said to myself, "Blimey, where's my surprise?" But he hopped in his sleigh and gave his team a roar. It's time to return to the briny deep floor. Then just as I thought, it's me worst Christmas day, a parchment of paper flew down off the sleigh. And it was the best present I ever got. A map to a treasure. X marks the spot. I laughed and I danced and I shouted with glee as up went his sleigh and then down to the sea. But I heard him exclaim, here he splashed near the star. Merry Christmas, be buckaroos, and a happy new year! Well, hey, that's the end of the book, everybody. That was A Pirate's Night Before Christmas by Philip Yates. Hey, I just wanted to say thank you for taking a few minutes to watch Storytime. Now go ahead and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss a Storytime, okay? Oh, and don't forget, like this video. What?
Thank you.